Now, a new survey has found the British public miss going to the gym or a fitness centre considerably more than any other sporting or leisure activity. Research from Sport England has found 87% of gym members were likely to resume their membership once facilities had reopened after lockdown. We can talk now to Gyro Junior, who's an international fitness instructor and industry trainer based in Sicily. Gyro's company Cross Cardio currently trains fitness instructors to operate over the web. Before lockdown, he'd travel around the world to teach. He also works at a gym and it's back open. So let's talk about people's habits and what's happening in the gym now it's gone back there in Sicily. Hello, welcome. Thank you for joining us. So let's talk then about how it's actually operating there, first of all.
Hi, hello everybody. Thanks very much for the invitation. And very glad to be here with you. Yes, now we in Italy, we are back. The lockdown is over. We started the phase two, and we started very slowly back to the activities. And what you just said is right. And many of the people, most of the people who's coming back to the gym, they're still a little bit afraid to get back to the activities. During the COVID, we had thousands of people that's really been working and training with us on web, and that was a really good thing because we really wake up people for the needs of training themselves to keep their healthy. Now, when the COVID is over, people wanna go back to the gym, but most of them still wanna train at home because they feel safe.
Yeah, I mean, I was wondering about that because obviously habits have changed, and actually working out at home with a trainer on the screen has been really effective for so many people. So how many people are actually coming back through the doors of the gym?
Well, I work one of the most important clubs in Italy. I work for this company that calls Virgin Active, and for sure you know them because in England they're very famous too, mm-hmm. in the fitness industry. And this company here, for example, in Italy, they have less than 50% of the clients get back into the club, even because we working differently right now. We reduce the capacity to have less people and to keep the distancing. So that was one of the actions that we had to help to people to come and train safely. But I think this kind of measures at the same time that it's going to, we're doing for helping people, it creates more, people get more afraid about that because they still thinking you cannot be close to the other people. And so people don't feel really comfortable about this thing. So most of the people in this moment in Italy prefer to go outside, to go running, to go training, workouts, outdoor trainings. It's very in this moment, it's very trendy here in Italy.
I mean, even socially distanced inside a gym, it's an environment where obviously people get sweaty, breathing yeah. heavily. How much distance does there have to be for people to feel safe?
Well, the measures here say is about 2 meters from each person. So if in four meters square, it's the area you have for yourself. So you imagine a room where you have the capacity of 80 meters, which means you have to have at maximum 20 people. So a big room will have maximum 20 people. And you're right about what you just said, because people sweaty, people get and these things really get people get afraid about of that, and so most of the clients don't really want to go to the fitness clubs in this moment. In fact, for example, most of my personal clients, 90% of them don't want to go to the club right now. They prefer to go outside, or they prefer if once the lockdown is over, if I can, to go in their house, to train them in their house. They feel safe like this.
In your experience, what has lockdown done generally to people's levels of fitness? Because, of course, there are people who would regularly keep fit who may or may not have been continuing that through lockdown in other ways, as you described. But also, I wonder whether there are people that have taken up fitness in a way that they didn't before, because there has been so much online that has been very accessible.
Well, to be sincere, what we had with the number says, the KPI says that we had 300% more people training during the COVID-19. That was an amazing result. For example, our company was doing classes online. You have a lot of people, and most of the other companies were also training people online. So most of the people that normally don't go to the fitness club, they discover workout trainings online. So that was a very good thing. I mean, I think people really realize that they can also train anytime they want. It's just a kind of mindset, you know, because many of the time people don't want to go to the fitness club to train, or they feel like they don't have time, or they get like lazy to go and drive back and arrive and change their clothes after one day working. But now, once the COVID comes up and everybody has to be locked down, people realize that they can even train at home. So you woke up in the morning, you take 40, 30 minutes for yourself, and you really will start an amazing day. So that's our advice. And that's what we discover in this moment, that really it can help a lot of people. And I think in this moment, we have more people that have been practicing workout at home before, when people were just going to the fitness clubs.
Yep, it gets your day off to a good start. Gyro Junior, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, it was my pleasure.